Me acompaña en la mesa presidencial, a mi izquierda, la coordinadora de PSOE Spain, doña Paola González. A mi izquierda, también inmediata, la delegación del excelentísimo Ayuntamiento de Elche, doña Patricia Maciá. Y a mi derecha, la presidenta de PSOE Spain, doña Ani Altamira. Now first, I would like to give the floor to the president of PSOE Spain, Mrs. Ani Altamira.
Thank you very much. Ms. Patricia Maciá, Dr. Vicente Micol, ladies and gentlemen, as president of PSOE Spain, I am really pleased to welcome you to a very special event. This is PSOE Spain's 40th annual convention. I'm here at Miguel Hernández University in Elche. Since 1977, when PSOE Spain was born, we have seen methods come and go, from grammar-based methodologies to the communicative approach to CLIM. Technology has moved from audio cassettes, overhead projectors, and language laboratories to CDs and computers, notional, functional, communicative, self-access, TPR, student-centered, cooperative learning, blended learning are only but a few of the ELT buzzwords over the years. But how do we view our history now? Are some trends returning? English has become a vital tool for learners' personal and professional development in Spain, but are we involving everybody in the process? What do we need to do to become more inclusive of different voices in our classrooms, in our schools, and in our profession? Students face increasingly harder challenges, and we, teachers, must also measure up. Although technological advances are shaping the teaching-learning paradigm anew, humanity is faced with more challenges of a diverse nature. This situation demands that teachers try to educate students in stronger values and become more tolerant of diversity. Our theme this year, Evolving and Involving, invites us to reflect on these and other issues. It is for these reasons that we hope you take advantage of this weekend to find talks, workshops, roundtables, resources, ideas, inspiration that will help all of us reflect on our views of teaching and how we want our practice to develop from now on. Apart from the wealth of presentations on offer, the convention also provides plenty of opportunities to socialize and network during coffee breaks, at the opening cocktail today, and the convention dinner tomorrow. I would like to thank Paola González, our convention coordinator, for the hard work and the time invested in organizing this convention. A special thank you to Julia Miquel and Lindsay Clanfield, Vicente Micol Molina, Africa Martinez Poveda, everybody here in the university. Thank you so much.